Eighth graders, this is to help you with question eight on CR24. It says, which graph represents a proportional relationship? How do you know? For the graph that represents a proportional relationship, give the unit rate. Okay, so as I look at these two graphs, to be proportional, the graph will be a straight line through the origin. So both of these graphs represent straight lines. However, this one doesn't go through the origin. Not proportional. Because although it is a straight line, starts here and goes up at a constant rate, it does not pass through the origin. There you have it. It would have to pass through the origin. Coral's earnings, on the other hand, is a proportional relationship. The graph is a straight line. Through the origin. It's a straight line through 0, 0. That's totally a proportional relationship. Therefore, we can find the unit rate. The unit rate. We would compare earnings over hours, and our unit rate would be how much do you earn per 1 hour? That's a unit rate. So I can read it right off the graph if I'd like to, but in case, is there any other nice points? I don't really see other nice points. So hours worked, one. Amount of money earned, $7. So it's $7 for 1 hour. Just trying to see if there's any other nice points. But I don't see other nice points. I was trying to show you on your graph. I don't know if it will cross nicely. But if you have X comma Y, the unit rate will be where your X value is 1. The Y will give you your unit rate. So wherever X is 1, that Y value gives you your unit rate. Or you can do, I'm sorry, not X over Y. For your constant proportionality, it's Y over X. Y over X, in this case, money over hours, gives you your unit rate. All right. I hope that helps. So your unit rate is $7 per hour. Oh, sorry about that. Oh, God. Oh, God. We're going to keep. I hope that.